This is the Fantasy Junction. This is a private collection. Incredible amount of cars. This direction. A lot more back there. Look at this.
Woo! It's hard to believe this place is here. You guys have been in this location for 89. So they've been here far longer than Pixar. And the funny thing was is, you wouldn't know by the outside the gyms that are inside. I think that's probably purposeful that, you know, you just walk right by this place. But going back to the first cars, we came here quite a bit to look at the cars they have here because a lot of these cars are original paint, so we could look at single stage paint or, you know, how a car oxidizes or even sounds or smells or whatever. We got so much inspiration that they became friends with us, and then as I start hosting the Motorama, they start bringing cars over for the Motorama. So in the early years of our Pixar car show, the nicest cars we had were the Fantasy Junction cars, which they would bring over. So.
Fantasy Junction. This is a company that works at Pixar in studying reflections and all the different things that they need to do for Cars 3, the upcoming movie. A very impressive collection of cars. These guys have sold 8,500 cars, all like this. I'll take any one of them.
It was $4,500 also, and his wife actually said, look, David, there aren't very many of those, why don't you just get that, we'll do the kitchen later. And then when he passed away, we sold this to the current owner for $8.3 million.
Like everybody just sort of got, when he said $8.3 million,
yeah. Anyway, he did the restoration, and this was the San Francisco Auto Show car, so.
The Cars 3 team, I'm almost flabbergasted because we saw 40 minutes of this movie. You guys are gonna flip a brick when you see this because there was so many things to absorb in such a short period of time. You guys did a phenomenal job.
Oh, thank you.
I don't even know how to really express it. How technically masterful Cars 1 was and how such an advancement this one is. Jay, being the production designer, what is it that's something that you would want people to come away with in watching this film?
Well, I think the scope of the film is kind of what I had to tackle in the making of it, was how many characters we had to design in the amount of time that we had, and as well to convey these armies of characters. Like, we have a full, all these races, all these NASCAR races.
We have so much, so many levels of detail.
Well, yeah, the graphic design alone that it took just to kind of bring the viewer into this world is staggering. I mean, every
then we have the legends,
and then we have the Crazy Eight race.
Right.
So we have all these groups of characters.
Yeah, that's basically what we do. Is we take the car that Jay's designed and Michael's team have built and shaded and rigged, and then it's kind of like giving the movement to the characters. And for cars, we're basically looking at the way that they drive and the race. And trying to,
that's almost the easy part, right?
Yeah, kind of is.
To do the driving stuff.
Well, we want everyone to have kind of like a unique style of driving. So Jackson Storm is a next-gen racer. He's a little bit different to McQueen. He's new, he's high-tech, he's precise. The other thing that we're responsible for is the way that they act and the way that they, gesture.
It's interesting because, with the driving, you kind of have to get that right. But the way they act, it's almost like a choice.
Yeah.
You have to sit there and decide, how do you want these guys to act?
Yeah.
And that's a whole world unto itself.
Oh, yes.
But for someone like you, you're juggling all these different characters,
we are,
right?
Yeah, our department really sits in between art and animation and a number of other departments. And so our job is really to take the designs that have come out of the art department and figure out how to build them in the computer digitally.
Yeah.
We're digitally modeling and sculpting the cars.
Just so many layers.
A designer and a CAD or a real car gets designed in the computer. We're doing something very similar to that. Mm-hmm. And then just like a real car goes to a paint shop, we're doing the same thing but virtually. And so, our technology for Cars 3 is super, super like detailed and realistic now, where we can control the metal flake and the color of the paint and the clear coat shininess versus the paint shininess and just all these different details.
Yeah.
And then what we do is we go through and it's kind of like setting up a puppet.
Mm-hmm.
We're virtually in the computer setting up all the controls that the animators will use. So there's hundreds and hundreds of controls just in each of the cars alone.
Yeah.
I think for me the funnest part I think was watching Fritter get designed. Watching her as that school bus kind of got ironed out and just watching it, like the modeler work on that, work with the art department really interactively.
Sure.
And just watching how that came together with the effects and the mud and the dirt and just the whole Crazy 8 sequence is just a lot of fun.
Yeah, Crazy 8 is exactly the term I'd use. What's your best story?
Oh, I was going to say Crazy 8 too, because the group of us animators got together with the story artists and just had a big old gag session just so we could figure out what kind of fun it is.
I know, I'm pretty sure someone said, what is the craziest thing that we could possibly come up with?
Yeah.
Because that sequence was a blow mind, because it's so visceral.
Yeah.
Bill Cohn, who's my co-production designer, who was responsible for environment design, rented a white Camaro and just blasted across the countryside and just stopped and took pictures of environments and beautiful landscapes. Mm-hmm. Found this little Dixie racetrack inspired kind of the Crazy 8 racetrack.
Mm-hmm.
It had that really beautiful red Georgian clay. And then just saw this beautiful landscape and old rusted cars. And
such inspiration.
Took it all in.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you guys have done a phenomenal job. Well, I think this movie does a few things really well. I've said this already, and I still believe this, that this is probably the most emotional of the three Cars films. I think this thing has the deepest stakes in terms of what McQueen goes up against and what he has to come back from. I think this film goes deeper. I think we saw that a little bit in the teaser with, the McQueen crash really scared a lot of people and put them on their heels.
Yeah.
And we did that to just say, this is not going to be, we could have easily done a happy-go-lucky, made a McQueen fun romp, but we really wanted to have him move some stakes.
I think that, I don't know if it's just specifically NASCAR, but I think motorsports in general is still healthy and going in a good direction. Because everybody said they had the first race the day they built the second car. And as long as there's machine, whether they're driving autonomous cars on the road or not, I think it's always going to be a competition level. Can I build a faster machine than you? Am I a better driver? So I think the engineering and design people will always move forward with some kind of motorsport.
It is exciting. It's funny, you were talking about autonomous cars, and I thought, it's interesting, but at the same time, what gets me about racing is not two cars going around the track, but it's actually two drivers. if I'm not invested personally with the person driving the car, when I see them banging fenders with somebody else, I'm rooting for somebody. I want to see gladiators, right? I want to see guys battling in the arena.
The most interesting thing about this is that you guys have made me fall in love with inanimate objects over the years.
Yeah.
That is quite a thing, because when you watch one of these movies, whether it's Toy Story or Finding Dory or Cars especially, since I'm that, anybody can go and see this stuff and fall in love with these characters. And like you said, it's really the character first and then the type of car later.
Yeah.
You guys have done a phenomenal job. And
thank you.
I commend you. And I'm a little frustrated because I really want to see the end of it, but I'll try to be patient.
Yeah.
What do you drive now? What's your daily?
I usually like to ride a motorcycle. I'm more of a bike guy because of just traffic. I have a Moto Guzzi, but I've got a little small Mercedes called the GLA 45, the little hot hatch, which is a blast.
Those are beautiful.
It's a great little car.
Yeah, how about you, Ray?
Every day I drive a Jeep Sahara, raised up, winch, big old mud rails and everything.
You got to come to Malibu then.
Yeah, that's a thing.
All right, John, we're done.
This is unbelievable.
That was an incredible experience here at Pixar. Really amazing. Great group of people. Learned so much about the upcoming movie.
Insightful.
Very insightful. They know what they're doing. You guys are going to love Cars 3. Make sure you go and see it. We got to go home now.
It's a long week.